31%. Jesus Christ. I thought I was like way higher than that. Shit. Wow. So we are now Alucard. Oh, I can't go this way. Oh. Damn you, game. Oh, we already got a dead guy.
As soon as I entered the Great Hall, I felt drawn to the mysterious mirror in the center. The world reflected in it trembled with every step I took until it disappeared entirely. Completely, rather.
I can read.
I saw a terrible vision of a pale man kneeling beside my corpse, examining the last entry on my screws.
Did he mean me?
That's right, he doesn't have a roll, he has a dash.
Is the game too easy for you? Ha! Huh.
Hey, buddy.
Okay, all right, so what does Alucard have? Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. Alucard is a vampire who is susceptible to fall damage. Great. I don't know if I have a climby whip. Okay, yes, he does. Sorry, we're gonna be a coffee fuck tonight.
The large bell located atop the clock tower was once used both to indicate the time and send warnings to the inhabitants of the castle of imminent attacks. I pray the day comes in which the throng is heard again, as a sign of victory over of light over darkness.
That was fucking bullshit. I thought there was something there. Is there anything even worth having up there? No, right? Really? Now, let's see.
The gargoyle leapt from the columns and landed by my side with a look of curiosity. I began to get rid of my belongings in the hope of distracting them. First, they chewed with pleasure on my sword, then my boots, my helmet, and finally a dagger. What fascinated them was the taste of my magic medallion, which is now lost to me.
Way to go. I got a feeling I'm gonna get killed here.
I tried dashing underneath him. Oh, I wonder if I have any magic. Nope. There we go. But now we have to do all this again, which is a little ridiculous. Motherfucker! Unbelievable. I didn't let go of that fucking button. Fuck, and now I gotta fight these assholes again. Alucard's certainly starting off on a bad note. Huh, I can't whip while crouched. Down lower, huh? I don't know what I'm supposed to do here. I dropped and I almost died. I have no idea how to get to this fucking door. Ugh. I can't believe it. I'm stuck. Did I miss something? No, I didn't miss anything. Dead. Oh, wow. It's amazing how some fall damage, like, the difference in height is inches. Ugh. For some reason, that chain isn't activating. So bizarre. Alright, so there's a chain thing there. Am I intimate with this? Minutes, I've made no progress. Jeez. Great, a boss fight with no fucking health. Alucard might be over-accessorizing.
Look at what you've become. You don't remember me, do you?
I don't know, I guess that was unblockable.
I have been waiting for this moment for a very long time. Burn and die!
Wait, was I not supposed to beat him? I don't know if I have oxygen as a vampire. I guess I don't. Why would this succubus one be down here? So I guess that was scripted. bat projectile. Okay. Oh, I wanted him to suck her blood so I could have a little more health. Oh, you bitch. Okay. Oh. Oh, for fuck's sake. Hey, buddy. Scattered throughout the castle, I've noticed strange doors adorned with the shape of a beast. Based on my research, these seals seem to have been installed to limit access for the weaker creatures to certain parts of the castle. I wish I had the strength to break them and discover the secrets hidden on the other side. Oh, I thought that would be water under here for some reason. Since one of these guys have electrical powers, were they Blanca? Wow, that would have been great. You could only see it. Oh my god, that is so fucking annoying. Better be a health mode over here. That was bullshit. Hey! You know, for something that can't be dodged, those fish do an a surprising amount of damage. Okay, I can't reach there yet. When we arrived on the shore, it became necessary to build a small raft to reach the other side. We used our armor as improvised oars until the water monsters snatched them away from us. We had but one option left: get rid of our weapons and try to swim to shore and hope that we would survive. Some would survive, excuse me. Hmm. It says it's a secret here. I don't see one. Yep, they're invulnerable. Oh, just tracking these down to hit them is a pain in the ass. Harpy leader. Ooh, the leader of the harpies. Yeah, I thought there were three, not, like, continual. Okay. I was gonna say, if I fucking fall... I never took the elevator down, did I? There was an elevator down. Oh, fucking unbelievable. I don't trust this fucking game. Man, now it's bugging me I didn't go check that elevator. Fuck me. I gotta go back. Nice of them to refill that for me. Was it here? Somewhere around here, though. Gotta be a way down to get that thing, too. It was there. Problem is, I don't think I can get there from here. Oh, there it is. Okay, yeah, now I remember. It's all coming back to me now. Watch out for the steam! I thought this was a way down to like another level. I keep hitting that thing a goddamn second too late. Water began to rush into the cave before I could take off the heavy armor I was wearing. I held my breath and swam with all my might to the surface, pulling off as many pieces of metal that protected me as fast as I could muster. But alas, the faces of my wife and children haunt me as the darkness surrounds me. Too late. A merman tadpole? That's what those little shits are? Oh shit. Thankfully there's one of these things right here. Ugh. Now just knowing those things are mermaid babies make them that much worse. Oh, for fuck's sake. They better not respawn. Well, that took an inordinately long amount of time. Electric merman. That's just silly. Come on, Alucard, you got it.
My superiors demanded I search these rusty pipes to look for the corpse of a missing comrade. Apparently he was the bearer of an important message. Sadly, all I found is a scroll consumed by mold. And myself, also consumed by mold.